Today we're going to be talking about the Bobcat depth check system. The Bobcat depth check system is in fact exclusive to the Bobcat excavator. It actually relies on componentry that is standard or optional equipment on Bobcat excavators, and it needs those other items to function. So to start out from a component standpoint, depth check itself includes a sensor on the bucket linkage. It includes a sensor on the arm, and it includes a sensor on the base of the boom. So the system essentially consists of the three sensors that are inclinometers. The inclinometers are basically telling the exact position of the boom, the arm, and the attachment, which in this case is a bucket. These sensors are constantly sending data back to the machine's control unit. That control unit is processing it essentially instantly, and then sending that data and information onto the Bobcat Deluxe display screen. And it's transferring information that the operator needs either in a visual form and or an audible signal to guide the operator to either sustain a desired grade or to achieve a desired dig depth. It's a wired system that gives us a little bit of flexibility as far as avoiding batteries and or solar charging systems. It also gives us the flexibility to submerge. Oftentimes on some applications, we'll see this sensor actually submerged in water, and with a wired system, we're still able to pull a signal back into the controller and continue the process digging and guiding the operator. The Bobcat depth check system is applicable to the E32 through E55. So our 3.5 ton excavator all the way up to our 5.5 ton excavator. The machine has to have the current forward mounted instrumentation, and furthermore, it has to have the deluxe panel, the optional deluxe panel. It needs that system to process, display, and provide operator input. You'll see four kits that are available for that span of machines, and the kits applicable machines depend upon the arm configuration on the machine, be it standard or long arm, and whether the machine has an angle blade or not. The key perhaps to remember is the depth check is not compatible with an extendable arm. I'm going to show you quickly how to access depth check on the Bobcat Deluxe display screen. I'm on the home screen at the moment, and to get to depth check, I need to toggle over to my attachment menu, and from the attachment menu, I will move attachments until I find depth check. I've found depth check, and now I'm going to say yes, and now this brings me right directly to the default depth check digging screen. I'm going to walk through the deluxe display panel, which is needed for depth check on the machine. And just to get started, the number one button correlates to the bench. The bench is a critical function of depth check. It's used to essentially tell the machine where the start reference point is. We'll use bench function every time we move the machine and reset and prepare to dig again. The next button down is tools. If I press tools, it gives me a menu of four items. That's where we can establish depth targets. You can preset five depth targets in the system so that you can quickly access them as you're digging. And then we can move to grade zone. Grade zone is the zone where you deem is an acceptable range plus or minus your actual target. That's an adjustable number at your discretion. Warning zone is the is what we call the area where you're approaching your target. So the system gives you an audible and a visual alert that you're approaching your target, and there too you can set that at your discretion, whatever you feel is acceptable. And this screen is also where you would set the laser receiver position if you are running a laser system with depth check. Also in the tools is the select an attachment. With depth check, you have to You have to install and calibrate each and every different attachment that you're going to be running with the system. And then you'll establish a list of five attachments that you can quickly pick from as you're working. And we can pick those from the main menu with just two clicks on the system. And then we also have setup and calibration. Setup and calibration really is going to be used when the system is installed on a machine. There are sensitive items in there. When we're in setup and calibration, we actually limit that to require a password to get into that system so that someone doesn't inadvertently go in there and change one of those critical settings. The other button we can pick is your preferences. There are three digging screens that you can choose to use with Depth Check, and we'll walk through those later. The other, but another item in the preferences screen is the units of measure. And with Depth Check, you can pick inches, feet, meters, or millimeters. So if I back out, return to the main screen, I'll show you the three different screens that you could choose from to dig with. This is one of the three. This is a grade check screen, and basically what this tells you after you bench your attachment, it will tell you a rise over run and a slope percentage. So as I move the bucket towards me, the screen will display the lateral movement towards me of the bucket tooth, and it will also display the rise if I were to raise that tooth up in the air and calculate instantly a slope percentage for me. The other screen that we would pick is an alternative to the default screen, and that's another variation of a distance to target screen. We have a blue arrow that points us down to target, an orange arrow if we're too low, it will direct us back up to our target. In essence, functions very much like the default screen, just a different screen to suit operators' preferences. Below the tool setting, we have a number three button that can turn on and off the audible alert. There's different preferences. Some people want to hear an audible alert as opposed to watch for a visual. So you can turn that on or off at your discretion. As I'm in the main digging screen, I mentioned earlier the depth targets that I had preset. In the digging screen, I can quickly pick my depth target screen, and I can change depth targets depending on what it is that I want to do in the particular dig cycle. So they're quick and easy to get to, and all I have to do is bounce back to my main digging screen. So the system is telling me with the chirp now that I'm approaching my depth target. And the screen is also visually telling me that. The red bar is my bucket tooth. And as I approach target, I'll hear a solid audible pitch. And my screen is telling me I'm on target. I'm within my grade zone. As I dig below, I will now hear a fast-paced chirp. That's signaling to me audibly that, hey, you've gone beyond your depth target. You need to come back up to achieve and stay on your desired grade zone. When I'm done with depth check and I'm going about other excavation or lifting or work with the machine, to get out of it, I simply press the home key and it returns me to the machine operating screen. So when we talk about applications of depth check, I kind of like to break it down into three different categories of using the system. The first would be simply going out to maintain a minimum cover type task. In that situation, you're simply trying to achieve a minimum depth relative to the surface, easily attained with depth check alone, exclusive of laser. The second type would be to use the system to sustain a grade, and the example would be footings in the bottom of a trench. If you have a known grade level, subgrade level that you have to achieve, depth check works wonderful for that, to sustain that level bottom trench, irregardless of the surface configuration, the service topography. Then the third gets a little more complicated. It introduces the laser aspect, the laser accessory into and on top of depth check. And that would be to either achieve a desired subgrade, sustain a desired subgrade, or to achieve and sustain a desired slope. That kind of drives the necessity of the laser on top of the depth check system.